Yes, I am. Yes, yes, I am. I am a Rush Limbaugh fan. I make no apologies for it, and if you hate me for it, head away. I find him wildly entertaining. I'm very apolitical, which is an odd statement to make, I suppose, after having confessed that I'm a fan of him, because he's all politics. I am so not interested in politics. However, if I were to be interested in politics, I would very much fall probably along the leanings of Rush Limbaugh. I would very much consider myself a conservative. But no matter how you feel about Rush and his political leanings, I find him just wildly entertaining and very witty and a lot of fun. Just a lot of fun. I keep notebooks, as you may know. Here is one said notebook. Don't know when I wrote this, but it was months ago. I can kind of tell by the notes in front of and behind. I probably should date these things, but I don't. I just kind of randomly draw or write. Here's the quote. I think it's a quote. I didn't succeed at much of anything there, but it all led to my success. I don't even remember what he was talking about. I don't know if he was talking about his work for the Kansas City Royals. I don't know if he was talking about one of his many excursions in radio. Failed excursions, I might add. I didn't succeed at much of anything there, but it all led to my success. I often tell people, listen, it's the process. And sometimes people just get really upset with that. They don't like it at all. And some people get worked up about it. You know, don't tell me it's about process, you know, but it is. It's a, there's a learning curve. There's an experience curve. There are these curves in our life. And if we want to get the curve going in the proper direction, I tell you what it's like. And anymore, I rather love this metaphor, and I am a man given to metaphors. I'm a man given to some stories. If a tractor trailer rig, if a big 18-wheeler is going to make it up a steep grade ahead, yep, you guessed it. They have to go down. They have to go down with some good momentum in order to be able to propel themselves up over said grade. You like that? So do I. And I like it not only because I just do, but I like it because I think it's powerfully simple. And it's easy for us to understand, and we instinctively, I think, have some idea of momentum, and we have these ideas of how momentum can shift, and you just see it all around you. Now, I'm a hockey guy. You knew that already. I don't know what the statistics are, but it seems in my viewing, in my watching of hockey, it seems to happen very frequently. The team rushes the puck. They go into the attack zone. That is the zone that they're trying to score. And they crash the net. They take a shot. There's just a terrific save. And, I mean, it seems like they have got the other team on their heels, but their goalie just makes a spectacular save. They've all rushed the net, and all of a sudden that forward momentum that they have, they've lost it. And all of a sudden the backward momentum that was going against the other team, it shifts that quickly. And the next thing you know, the other team is now rushing toward their net with huge momentum, sparked by the fact that their goaltender had to, as we say in hockey, stand on his head to make a save. And the other team comes back and they score. You see it. You see it with enough regularity that everybody who has been any kind of a fan of hockey and has watched hockey for any length of time knows it. understands it. One team is pushing forward. Man, it just appears that they've got everything going in their favor. Everything looks just perfect for them to score. But they don't. And the other team seems to escape by the skin of their teeth. And all of a sudden, you can just see this huge pendulum called momentum just begin to swing in the other direction, and the other team comes back and they put it in the back of the net. You see it in other sports too. You see it in sports where one team just has a great defensive stand. In football, the other team is, you know, they're down on the 2-yard line. It's fourth and goal. They've tried to get this ball in the end zone, and they have not been able to do it, but they've got one more chance. And you see these big hulking linemen dig in, and here's the last play for them to get it in the end. And if they don't, their thought is, you know, okay, we've at least pinned the other team back on their own 2-yard line. I mean, come on, it doesn't get much better than that. But we need the points. We really need the points. And they go for it, and they're stymied. They appear to have had all the momentum going in their direction. I mean, you can get a little bit closer, but you can't get much closer. Rejected, turned away. And you think, well, they've got the other team pinned back. But that momentum, that shift in momentum propelled because their defense was able to keep the other team out of their end zone, that gives spark, quite frequently, that gives spark to now that team's offense coming onto the field and moving the ball. We see it. We see it all the time. But when it comes to our life and when it comes to our experiencing the momentum, whether that momentum is shifting in a negative way or whether it's shifting in a positive way, I think the problem is sensation. I think the problem is our ability to sense. Where are we? Oh, I'd love to tell you I have the answer for that. I don't. Therein is the problem. Welcome to the human race, and welcome to the process. The process is so frustrating because we don't know where we're at. And in so many ways, we don't have any way to know where we're at. Oh yeah, you know, you can look at all the metrics. You can measure everything you want to measure. But when it comes to us being able to tell, are we succeeding or not? And define success any way that you choose. Let's define it by whatever your goal is, whatever your objective is. Am I closer to it? I mean, somebody please tell me that I'm at least getting closer. Am I headed in the right direction? You know, it's this huge game of warmer, hotter, colder. It's kind of like a game of Marco Polo. I mean, just, am I close? I can't, I'm listening. I've got my bat ears going to try to get the sonar happening so I can tell, am I moving further away from where I'm wanting to go, or am I getting closer? It's very, very hard to tell. Have you ever experienced a time where you thought, man alive, I'm not making any headway at all. I am so far away from even being close to where I hope to be. And within the span of a few days, it's as though there's just been this seismic shift. We've had it happen. We've had it happen when out of the blue, good news comes our way. When out of the blue, some new business comes our way. Now, more often than not, we've done some things to put ourselves in those positions. But for whatever reason, it just, well, the boldness, our courage, our tenacity, it just sometimes it pays off. And sometimes there are these defining moments that you can definitely tell, you can quantify, but boy, so much of it is just the process. So much of it is just day to day doing things and being able to say, much like Rush did, I didn't succeed at much of anything there. Hard to tell at the time, but we can look back and perhaps like him, we can conclude, but it led to my success. That's what I wish for you. I wish for you success. My name is Randy Cantrell. The website is BulaNetwork.com. Till next time, see you.